Hello, how are you? I hope you're good. Welcome back. Today we are creating a VIP list of the TBR books that I want to read. Grab yourself a drink, a snack, anything to make your stay more fun and enjoyable, and let's go through the 20 books that I've picked.
We don't go the same places that we used to go.
This is a list that I will be using for my TB avatar if I ever land on a D20 tile. What it means is that I will create a list of 20 books and then I'll assign them a number on that list and I'll roll the D20 die, read that book. A very easy concept. It was included in a fairy loot box as a TBR game and very easily replicated at home as well. And I thought it would be a very good way to implement into my TBR game something that will let me still have the fun of a chance, like the cabbage pot that I have, but with a more curated list of books that I actually really am keen on reading or am procrastinating on reading. So today we're making that list. There is a couple books that would have definitely made the list, but they're not on the list because they are actually a part of a different project that I'm doing. Just in case you're thinking, like, gee, I know you've been really wanting to read this or that, and then it's not there. So, because there are 20 books on the list, I won't go into a lot of detail about them, but you probably have seen them floating around. But if it sparks your interest, obviously you can just do a quick Googaloo. So, in no particular order, these are the books that I'm making into my VIP TBR list. The first one is The Space Between Worlds. It has a lot of the buzzwords of the books that I personally enjoy. It has like a space-time travel, multiverse, and a little bit of a danger situation to do with that. And I'm very, very excited to potentially land on this. This would be, again, this is in no particular order. I might sort them in particular order later. I'm not sure. But if I could, this would be very high at the top. The next one is The Blade itself, primarily because I really want to read something by Joey Abercrombie, who is very well known in a kind of grim, dark setting. We follow a infamous barbarian, Jezahl Dan-Luthar, a fencer. And then the third character is a cripple turned torturer. From what I've heard, it's a very character-based story, which really intrigues me because I am primarily a character-driven reader. The next one I do have, but it's on the shelf. The first one in the second era of Mistborn. I've read the first one, really loved it. One of my favorite series, definitely the favorite ending. Because the second one is kind of reminiscent of a Western setting, which is not something I gravitate towards, but they are much shorter, and I do know that they're very well beloved. Some people even love it more than the first one, and it's about time I actually try and read that. I did try, I think, to start once, and I just didn't, I just got somewhere else. I don't know, I just forgot. You know how it is sometimes, but it is time that I get on that. The next one is an absolutely remarkable thing. This is following someone who takes a video of a mysterious statue that appears, and then overnight the video blows up and becomes viral, and then it's following that and also discovering what are these statues. This has been embarrassingly long on my TBR, but not only that, but the fact that I kept pushing it for the Patreon read and it just never won, like it's said, I can't do it anymore. I need to put it somewhere with like good chances of me picking it up. Like, watch the roll completely miss this entirely again. But maybe I just have this pull towards it. Maybe I won't even like it. Next is Anxious People, which is by Frederick Beckman, who is becoming one of my very liked authors. So naturally, really made sense to put another book of his on the list. And this one is in a situation where there is a bank robbery, but the robbery is kind of underwhelming, and then people who are being held hostage become a little bit irritated by the lack of pizzazz. And I think it is a very interesting concept, and I really want to see a take on this, and as well as hoping that it's going to be quite humorous. I do know that a lot of people say it's not his strongest of works, but it does really appeal to me. So I'm intrigued to see how I will feel about that. Next, we have Morningstar, which is a third book in Red Rising series. This is here solely for the reason that if I don't put it somewhere that I absolutely have to read it, I don't know if I will, and if I allow many more months to pass, I will simply forget enough of the story to not want to continue. So this one is here because I want to finish the series. Then we have Early Riser, and this is by Jasper Ford, whose writing I also am really intrigued by. I've never read anything by him, but I really want to try. And this is also like a humorous kind of take on a very dire situation. I think that a lot of the people are put into this like sleep for the very rough winters, but there's selected few that have to like oversee the process, and they investigate an outbreak of viral dreams, which you dismiss as nonsense, nothing more than a quirky artifact born of the sleeping mind. When the dreams start to kill people, it's unsettling. When you get the dreams too, it's weird. So it seems to be an interesting dystopian setting, and Logan actually read this and he really liked it, so I really want to get on that. And I have been wanting, again, this is a very big theme, I've been wanting for a while, but I just keep getting distracted by other things, and I don't know, I'm just very excited by the idea of this list. I hope that it will help me to get to the books that I've been trying to get to for so long, but apparently don't have the willpower to persevere. Which this definitely fits in. It's another Becky Chambers book. This is the third in the Wayfarer series, one of my absolute favorite series, even though I've only read two in the series. Record of a Spaceborn Few. I do not know much about it, but I really want to keep it that way. I love to go into her world and into the story blinded, but I love Becky's writing. I love the world that she creates, and I love the type of sci-fi that is character-driven and story-driven, and I'm very excited to read it. And I have been for... when was this released? 2018. So I have been since 2018. And Logan again read this, and I can let him constantly win. The sprinkle of slightly shorter stories in here as well. We have Before the Coffee Gets Cold. This is a sci-fi time travel exploration story, which again ticks a lot of boxes for me personally as a reader. This is a cafe where you sit in a particular spot and drink a coffee, and then you can go back and redo a particular decision that you've decided to redo and see how your life would have been, and then you have to come back before the coffee gets cold. I'm thinking that's the idea. It sounds like right up my alley, and I'm excited to see if it actually is. If you've been on my channel as well, you will definitely recognize this one. I've been trying to get to this for again, a very embarrassing... this is just me calling out myself for not reading these books sooner, let's be honest. Stories of Your Life and Others. This contains a short story that inspired one of my favorite sci-fi movies, which is called Arrival. Highly recommend. So it does have that story, but it has like, I don't know how many, 7 or so other stories. I'm not the biggest fan of short stories, but I think if I ever would, it would be those kind of short stories. Invisible Kingdom Volume 2, simply because I want to continue with the comic. This is another sci-fi one, where a religious regime clashes with a capitalist regime. Very interesting. And we follow two women from both worlds kind of colliding and trying to solve the corruption between the two sides. Or at least expose them. I'm not sure about solving. Then I have Song of Achilles. I just know that people cry at this, and I want to see if my cold heart will succumb to that. But I really also want to read something by this author because I know how beloved she is and how much praise for her writing there is. I wasn't sure whether to put Circe or the Song of Achilles in here, but I decided to go with this. For no particular reason other than the infamous ending that makes people very emotional. Do You Dream of Terror 2? One of my more recent additions to my library. This is another sci-fi where some people were selected because they trained all their lives to go on this mission to another inhabitable planet, I think. Because Earth is going to shit. A big theme in sci-fi currently because it's just like very much where reality is headed. Fun. But there's other people who can compete for the spot, as far as I remember. And the main character is one who dreamed since she was very young to be able to go there, and then she gets selected. But also said it will take the team 23 years to reach Terra 2, 23 years locked in close quarters, 23 years with no one to rely on but each other, 23 years with no rescue possible should something go wrong, and something always goes wrong. Similar to Invisible Kingdoms, I have Die Volume 2, another comic that I absolutely desperately want to continue. This is your Jumanji meets D&D type of story, but a bit darker. Now I have one that I absolutely, absolutely want to read so badly, but it is also extremely scary in size. And that is to sleep in the sea of stars. This is a weapon. I could just like exercise with this book and get pumped. I've never read Aragon because this is the author of that. I do remember seeing it on the shelves because it was one of those rare books that did actually get translated into Lithuanian, but I never, for some reason, picked it up. I don't know why, because all signs were there, but I just didn't. I've heard some great things, and I've also heard people just not making it through and DNFing. So I'm excited to see where I would be, but I'm suspecting on the love side. But this is a first contact sci-fi, which I also really love. Come up on the game, I probably will cry a little bit. But you know, maybe I'll discover something beautiful through my tears. Another completion to the series is about So Bold and Deadly. I really enjoyed the first and the second books. I know they're not for everyone, but the writing style just spoke to me. I really like the simplicity but impactfulness of it. I really like it. It's not like me to like retellings. I really don't gravitate towards them, and I often forget that this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. I was really keen on this after the second book, but obviously, like when you have to wait for them to be released, sometimes the hype dies down. And that's kind of like low key what happened to me, but I'm still very excited. I just need to pick it up. A contemporary, we have Beach Read, that this is where two writers meet and they are writing completely different genres. One is a romance, one is, oh, I don't know, like a memoir maybe or something. I actually don't know, maybe thriller? I'm not quite sure. Or like a literary fiction maybe. That would make sense. Both have come to like a writer's block and they decide to like swap genres that they don't really think highly of, perhaps? I'm not quite sure. But there's a lot of other things going on. I think there's grief, but I think there's also like, and obviously this is a love story, but I'm always up for exploring humans, and this seems to be that in like a beach read format, which is a market I'm behind. So another sci-fi is Kindred. This is actually a historical sci-fi, I guess, like a historical fiction sci-fi is obviously not historical. But it's in 1976, Dana dreams of being a writer. In 1815, she is assumed a slave. When Dana first meets Rufus on a Maryland plantation, he's drowning. She saves his life, and it will happen again and again. And since each time Dana saves him, the more aware she is that her own life might be over before it's even begun. And I'm very excited to read this because I've never actually read anything by Octavia Butler before, and it's one of the first sci-fi novels published by a Black woman. I want to know how it is. I want to know how I like it. So we have that. Then we have The Stone Sky, which is another completion of a series. This is the Broken Earth, or the fifth season for the first book. Again, I lost my drive for this series because of the second book. That wasn't bad, but it just wasn't as good as the first one. But I do really want to actually finish it and have it in my finished completed series list. And then the very last one is Malibu Rising. This is by the author who wrote Daisy Jones and the Six and Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. If I were to sort it by a priority, this would be quite low on the list. And there were a lot of books that would have taken this spot, but because I don't know, maybe I'm in the summer mood, but I really like the cover, and honestly, the cover stole the spot. That's all I'm gonna say. And I also did obviously very much enjoyed Evelyn Hugo a bit more than Daisy Jones and the Six. Daisy Jones and the Six to me sounded like it doesn't quite have the story. Maybe unpopular opinion. So I'm excited to see what the Malibu Rising is about. I know it's like it's set over a party. I don't know why I've piled all of my books in like a big stack and it's very wobbly now. But that is my list. If I happen to read any of these books for any other prompts, or just happen to read them, not because I rolled the die, that's totally fine. I will then replace it with some other book instead. So I'll just scroll it out and replace the slot with a new book that gets to go into the top 20. Let me know what are the books in your top 5 if you can narrow that down, because I would love to see that down in the comments below. Let me know if you've read any of these and if you liked them or hated them or anything in between. And I have some shout outs and massive thank yous for the Patreons who joined in the month of May. So the June is their first official month. Welcome to the Moony family. Thank you so much for picking the Moon Watchers or Moon Messenger tiers. I really appreciate your support more than I can ever actually like articulate. The warmest welcome to Jennifer, Beth, Katrina, Brittany. Oh, hi Zeus. to Katie, to Ashley, Cassandra, Marlon, Marcella, Nadia, Tamara, Amy, Joe, and Dominique. To those entirely new, welcome to the Patreon. To those changing the tiers, welcome to your new tiers. I really hope you enjoy it there. Thank you so much for watching. Stay awesome, stay kind, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!